Well, it shows how badly our kind of work is needed.
Absolutely,
because,
yes.
Because it is inconceivable. They need 60 votes on those, I believe.
Yes.
And didn't come close to that. And that is jolting in contemporary America, that we could have such barbaric acts supported by so many senators in this particular case. And the House of Representatives, where we minister primarily, has equal challenges and problems. The good news, if I can flip it to the positive news, is we probably have more, say in the House of Representatives, for example, we probably have more solid believers, Jesus, serious Jesus followers, than perhaps ever, or at least in all modern history. In the midst of all the horrible stuff that comes out of the House of Representatives, there are a group of tremendously godly, sacrificial people that people don't realize. They always say, throw the bums out and they're paid too high. This is not true. 20%, probably at least 20% of members of Congress cannot afford a condo, an apartment in D.C. and sleep on the sofas in their offices. The place where we meet with our Bible study, that member of Congress sleeps there in that room and gets it all ready and fixed up for us when we arrive at 7 a.m. in the morning for a Bible study. So there are a lot of people who are really seeking God, hungry for God, following the ways of God. They're very beat up in that place. Some of them are quite frankly discouraged, but they're standing strong in the midst of horrific gale force winds of evil that come out of them, as depicted by what you just described.
And when you talk about biblical principles of governance, so yes. You have a representative that goes to Washington, D.C., wants to live a godly life, be a godly man, a godly woman, sensing that God wants to use them in this circumstance. What do you say to them to say, this matters? These principles that we're teaching about biblical concepts of governance, this is important. How do you keep them encouraged and really moving forward when it would be so easy to be so frustrated?
Well, part of it is a ministry of encouragement, a Barnabas ministry. But let me just kind of flip it and say, rather than what I say, what some of them have reported to me. One member of Congress says, I cannot believe, this was back when I was still pastoring Skyline, I cannot believe that your church at that time has so sacrificed so members of Congress can have what we have in that worship service on a weekly basis and that Bible teaching that you provide. At that time, we were doing it on Wednesday evenings. Now we do it on Wednesday mornings. Another one almost was in tears one day. He was close to tears. He was a congressman from one of the East Coast states. And he says, I cannot believe you brought worship into the Capitol. And he looked at me and says, you brought worship into the Capitol. And he was so deeply moved. And another one from a congressman from the state of Texas just recently that I had never met before. And he says, oh, man, I can't tell you what I'm on that book. We used my book, Well Versed, which lays out the biblical foundations for 30 political topics. He says, I cannot tell you what that means to me. By the way, Bob, we not only do that in the Congress, but at the United Nations in New York City. We have weekly Bible studies in the United Nations for employees of the United Nations. Then we have monthly meetings for ambassadors. There are 193 member nations of the United Nations. We have met privately. I say we are a little team, well-versed. Wellversedworld.org is where people can find out about this. But our little team has met privately with 91 of the 193 ambassadors at the United Nations. Now, probably of those we've met with, probably about 10 are believers and the rest are not. Many of them are Muslims and such. But I'll give you an example of the encouragement we can. I said to the ambassador, for example, from a Muslim country, I said, sir, I notice in your country, you have 40% unemployment. 40% unemployment is devastating to your people. Your people are hurt. You know that. They're wounded. He says, yes, I know that. I says, you know what we do? We bring biblical principles of economic prosperity for a nation, what God's pattern is for a nation to enjoy economic prosperity so the people will do well. Can I have the privilege of praying for you right now? And so it opens the doors. What guy who's from a nation with 40% unemployment does not want to understand principles that would help his people? And so God's word is so good. God was so incredible. And when he formed the Bible, he not only put the Bible together in a way that addresses personal needs, family needs, church needs, but the issues of civil governance, that if a nation will follow him, that nation will be blessed. We have an exciting meeting, a ministry, exciting word to bring to people.